In this problem, it asks what we can conclude from this output from the Peng-Robinson equation state spreadsheet. So this is the equation state spreadsheet for mixtures from Elliott and Lira. It says assume that measurements are only good to two significant figures. And then the spreadsheet allows us to have multiple components, so we can do this for a given phase. We can put in the mole fraction, so Z can be either X or Y. We have to put in the critical pressure and temperature. In this case, if we put in the temperature to system and then the pressure in megapascals, it will calculate the composition of the phase. And it's asking us to reach some conclusions from this data only. An important thing to notice is, so the large volume is the vapor phase, that's the vapor. The small volume is the liquid. The in-between value is not a physically meaningful value. And so what we notice is that the fugacity of chloroform in the vapor is identical to fugacity of chloroform in the liquid. And likewise, the fugacity of the other component, hexane, in the vapor, and mixture notation equals fugacity in the liquid for hexane. So we would conclude vapor-liquid equilibrium because fugacity of individual components are equal. This is the fugacity value. The other thing we conclude, we only have one spreadsheet here, so saying for this mole fraction, the fugacities are equal in the liquid and vapor phase, meaning that it's the same mole fraction. So this means that X of chloroform is 0.75 and Y of chloroform is 0.75. Mole fraction, vapor and liquid, the same. This means we must have an azeotrope for this system. So we're at vapor-liquid equilibrium and we have an azeotrope.